Damilola has released another powerful series titled Gbemi. So Gbemi was released in 2019 and for so long we didn't hear from it. So we all thought that it was over. I was actually expecting Abatua to be the next after Abejoye, but then we saw Gbemi, meaning that when we weren't hearing anything from Gbemi, Damilola was working something behind closed doors. My name is Lydia once again and welcome back to Sahara Movies. If you are new to the channel, please don't forget to subscribe for more videos and more updates. Now let's delve into it. So the series started with a man praying earnestly, like he was really praying sincerely for a child. And according to the story, this man has been married for 5 years and to no childbearing, like to no forthcoming of a child. And it's natural for you to give up if you are using your own timetable. Let's say you tell yourself, I'll get married at 25, by 27 I should have my firstborn. You're already 35 and there's no child. That is your timetable because you decided to give yourself that calculation. But then God's timetable is you give it at 40. But then because you have drawn your own plan, coincidentally your plan of getting married at 25 came to pass, you'll be thinking that your plan of giving birth at 27 will also come to pass. But sometimes God can swerve you. He wants you to know that he's the boss. That is what happened. Unfortunately, in this marriage, the man is a man of God, but he has lost faith. For 5 years, if there's no child, you can lose faith. Like, you can lose faith. It happens. It's very real. You can lose faith. But fortunately for the man, his wife was very, very prayerful. He has a very prayerful wife who is very supportive to, encourages him that, don't worry, God's time is the best. Have you forgotten God's time is the best? And in everything, we should give thanks. Like, you know, those encouragement, those things that lifts you up when you are down. The wife was always willing to give it to him. On the other hand, there's another family, there's another couple. So this movie is focusing on two different couples who are facing two different challenges. I mean, this episode, two different challenges. So one was what I discussed earlier, Gbemi, who they are having issues with childbearing. Perfect family, but there's no child. The other couple, they have a child, but they are having issues like adultery, those cheating, you know what I mean. So they contradict different marital issues in marriages. People get married and the marriages are so young, because 5 years of marriage, no child, is a young marriage. You to date the other couple, I mean, Tara is married to, they have a child who should be about 6 years. They have a child, but the husband is cheating. It's also a very young marriage. So Damilola is focusing on the youth of today. We get married, it's like people are fancying the weddings and not the marriage. They are not really going into to start a family. They are just going into it because their friends, their colleagues, their enemies are all going into it. This woman was making a call with the mom, complaining about the husband and all that. And there was a stranger right behind him. I feel this scene should tell us that we should know who we talk to at a certain point, you know. If I have a phone and I'm discussing something sensitive in public, there could be anyone around me listening. Anyone who wants to do anything against me will be listening. And this stranger, Chooks, he was an agent sent to destroy her marriage. And he was at the right spot, at the right spot. And he offered to pay for the item she bought. This is how the devil finds way. You least expect it. Like, when you're facing issues with your marriage and a stranger offers to buy you something, you know, it's a blessing. Okay, funny enough, when you're facing issues with your marriage, I think it affects you financially. So if someone offers to give you to pay for your product, I think you even see that as a blessing, because he or she has financially raised some of your burden. The reason why I'm saying, when you're making calls, you should be careful, is because she was talking to her mom about her husband. And if someone is by you, wants to know more about your family, you have just exposed yourself through the phone call. So sometimes when you are talking on phone, we should just look around the people around. We should just look around to see who is around us. If the call is very important, we just lower our tone. That's how come there's earpiece. That's how come you can lower your tone. You can go to the washroom. Like, some calls are sensitive that shouldn't be heard by other people. I understand that sometimes we can be frustrated, we just talk anyhow, but we should just control what we can control. Like this woman, Tara's case like this. I feel she would have told her mom, I'll call you later when I get home. Then nobody knows about what's going on. Unless you want to broadcast your marital issue. But if you don't want to broadcast it, just try as much as you can to control what you can control. Moving forward, Gbemi's husband is also having issues with the family. At the same time, he's a counselor. Like, I don't know. Sometimes we go to psychologists, we go to doctors, we go to people to seek help and all that. Forgetting they are also humans and they also have emotions, they also have feelings, they also have families, they also have responsibilities. So sister Buke visits Gbemi's husband crying, I'm 37, I'll be 40 and I'm still single, I'm not married, I don't have a suit, I don't have a problems upon problems. Meanwhile, Mr. Man is also not having a child and he's praying, always praying over it, always fasting and praying, and his wife is telling him that wait upon the Lord in everything, give thanks. Like, even though his wife tells him this, he doesn't really have faith in what his wife says. But when Sister Buke came to him, he was using his wife's words to encourage her. At that scene, it will look so normal. Like it is normal because if you're a counselor, you are expected to meet people to pour their problems to you. But when it exceeds the normality of things, so Sister Buke then proceeded to bring him food. Like, how would you do that? Someone who is married, you bring him cooked food. If you bring him food stuff, it's different. But you bring him cooked food at the office. If you want to bring him food, his house. You can send a taxi to take the food to his house. I think that would be the safest, or that would be better. But then you walk straight to his office with food in ice chests, like in coolers. Give it to someone's husband. If you don't have a motive, why would you do that? That's why I said earlier that when you're making calls, you should be very careful. Because people around us have different motives. Honestly, people come into our lives with different motives. They just come like, okay, they are coming as friends. They come like they need your sympathy. They come like they need your advice. They need you. Some people also come like they are offering you help. In the first instance with Tara, Chooks came like he was offering help. In the second instance with Bemi's husband, Sister Buke came in like she needs help. So do you see, these are two pictures that are created. Like, people have different ways of coming into your life, but they have different motives, like crazy motives. If we are given the obligation to read into people's minds, I think we will be living on this world we will just be single every day. Like, we'll just be living as a singular human being, not depending on anybody else. That is if we know the motives. But because we don't have the power, the ability to know the motives of people, we just have to control what we can. So Bemi also accepted the food. Like, he acted like he hadn't eaten his entire life, and that is creating a wrong picture for Sister Buke. No, should I even say wrong picture? It's creating a right picture for him, because that is what she wanted to see. Because if I brought food to someone's husband and the person willingly accepts the food and was excited about it, it means a marriage is not going on so well. Honestly, people with motives, they know where the loopholes are. I think I'm going too deep, but they know where the loopholes are. I bring you food to your office, you accept the food, you are so excited about it. I know that there's something going on in your marriage. There's something going on with you mentally, emotionally, psychologically. And then I try to do it another time because I realized that, okay, this is a perfect place to hit. This is a vantage point I can take advantage of. That is what Sister Buke was doing. We need to be vigilant. We should be prayerful, yes, but we should add vigilance to it. You shouldn't just be prayerful and expect that magically everything will be solved. You do your part and you expect the prayers you are praying to also do its part. Yes. So I'm seeing that they are trying to brace towards two different issues. One is a marriage without a child, and the other is a marriage with a child but a cheating husband. They are going to diversify these marital issues and eventually solve them. We'll see how Damilola will come out with solutions to these marriages. I want to talk about Gbemi finding out that she's pregnant. So she missed her period and She told the husband that, "I've missed my period one day." That part, I think Bamiloye should have waited a while. You know, sometimes you just need to hold on. Just hold on. Even when you are sure, just hold on. You say, "Oh, but he's my husband." Yes, he's your husband, but you know him. He can't be quiet. You know how he's been waiting for a child. You know how he can be overwhelmed with such good news. I feel that Bemi should have kept it a bit longer to herself. Immediately, she told the husband, he just pressed it at the office. You know, there are different types of people and what they want. You know, when the husband was excited about it, he had good reasons to tell his colleagues, his friends, his peers, or his co-workers, but they have individual motives behind their news. To him, it was good news, it was the perfect news. But to Sister Buki, no, she didn't like it. She didn't like it at all, because the fact that their wife was barren was an opportunity for her to enter into the marriage. And now it comes out that she's pregnant, meaning she'll do whatever to get rid of the pregnancy. That is me, in my point of view. And if you And okay, eventually it came out that Bades lost the child. I mean, when they were doing the, you see, when they finished, they do another one, like to show us what will be shown next week. Came out that Bade lost the child, and I'm like, I am not surprised at this. Why couldn't they have kept this a secret? I know the husband couldn't have kept it a secret. Why couldn't Bade just have kept quiet and kept it from the husband? Like, it would be difficult, but you should know your husband. You should know the people you are around with. That's why they say it's not everybody that you should share things with. Even your own, someone so close to you, you should be careful about the things you tell them. I'm not saying you just filter. Just filter the news. I don't know. Just filter. We also came to know that Chooks was a scent agent. You know, I said earlier that people come into our lives like normal friends. We see them as friends, see them as colleagues and all that, but they have different motives. So Chooks was an agent sent by Tara's husband's, you know, one of those times when he was a lecturer and he was abusing ladies. You know, definitely you are gonna pay for everything you do, whether people try to pay it, let you pay it, or you pay it when you die, or you when you lose your life, like you pay eventually. She decides to pay back by ruining his family. Ruining Tara's family, you know. So he decides to send Chooks into the family, facing another issue on his own. So I feel like this is a very deep series that we should focus on, especially if you are entering into marriage, or if you're already in marriage. It is very relatable, because we have different issues. He even focused on just two, and we are seeing how things are turning out. It looks like Bade's faith will be tested, because right now, when she lost a child, I mean, in the what will be happening in the next episode, the mother-in-law was saying that she knows a pastor who is a specialist. And we know how false prophecies too have become very common in our days. People are just pretending to be preachers, or to be people spreading the word, but they are extorting money from people. So who is this specialist that Bade's mother-in-law is talking about? Sorry, Bemi's mother-in-law is talking about. Because I don't understand, what do you mean by a specialist? Or wasn't it a specialist she used? She used a specialist. She said she knows a specialist who is very, very good. I'm like, really? How can a man of God be a specialist? Let's see how Bemi's faith will be, because this is like testing Bemi's faith here. One, her husband is like, she's almost losing the husband, because Sister Buki has now taken up it. Like, she's now confident about her quest. She's not doing it in a subtle way. She's no longer sharing fruits. Right now she's taking hacks. She's taking hers, because the husband needs emotional support. And it's when you are emotionally down that people get into your heads very, very easily. When you are emotionally down, like, your mentality and everything is at the least, that is when people really get to you easily, because they know that, okay, this is the easy part that's like you've gotten. One part that the one what I like about this is, like, it's like the whole family of Bamiloye is inside. Bamiloye himself is inside, his wife is inside, and his mom is inside. It's like he has put his whole family in the movie, and that is what makes the movie very nice and very relatable. So let's see how this goes. I think that in the next episode, Bemi's faith is going to be tested, and it's not going to be easy. One from her mother-in-law and two from her husband, because Sister Baki is now going, like, she's going with chest out. And on the other hand, Tara's husband is saying that he's going to divorce the wife. Will she get a savior? Will someone from nowhere come and advise her to be prayerful? Because I don't see her to be a prayerful woman, even though her mother is always advising her to be. Let me know your thoughts on this. I'll be ending here for today. Let me know what you think about Gbemi Part 2, Episode 1. My name is Lydia once again. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe for more videos and more updates. Till next time, bye.